Good afternoon, everyone. Krista here from Georgia Soap Creations, back to make another soap. Today I'm making Pearberry Bed Bath & Body Works dupe. And in this bowl, I have already mixed my lye water in with my hard butters and oils. As you can see, they are almost melted. I decided to start the video when they were almost done to save us some time instead of you just sitting here watching me stir the bowl. And in my other bowl back here, I already have my liquid oils blended with my buttermilk powder and my kaolin clay. So we are going to go ahead and swap the stick blender over and get those added in. I pour it down over a spoon so that it does not splash the hot lye solution up onto me. Just a safety precaution that most soap makers do. And I've turned my fan off that I use in my basement to keep me cool. I'm hoping that that will help with the volume issues that I've been having. And hopefully you'll be able to hear me better on this video. This pearberry soap is going to be two colors, a light green and it's called strawberry red. I'm going to use those today to have more softer pastel looking colors to this soap, even though it is in my winter holiday lineup of soaps. Get a paper towel ready. You just never know when you're going to make a mess. So I like to try and be prepared. Now we'll get to blending this up. See if I can get my cord out of the way a little bit better. Tapping the stick blender burps the air bubbles out of it. Keep less air bubbles in the soap. Grab another paper towel and clean up the edge of this bowl. Go through quite a bit of paper towels when I'm making soap, and only when I'm making soap. When I make my other products, I don't go through hardly any paper towels. I'm just making a small batch of this today to start. I've never used this fragrance before, so I'm not sure on exactly how it's going to react. It's going to be predominantly green. The red is going to be an accent. And I think I'm just going to use the bowl that I had the liquid oils in to separate out. Let me check my other containers. I want something that's going to make it easier to pour. We'll use these two. Alright, set my stick blender aside for a moment until I get my batter separated out. into the red. And like I said, predominantly green now. But I do want to make sure I have enough red for the top of the soap for how I want to finish it off. At least what I've got playing in my mind right now anyway. As always, scrape every bit of that you can out of the bowl. Don't leave any of it behind. Otherwise, that's just a waste. Alright. It's about as good as it's gonna get. We'll set that to the side, clean up the dribbles. We're going to start with the green because the green that I'm using is lighter than the red. Alright, we'll start with that and go from there. That is perfect for the green color I was hoping to achieve. I don't know how well you can see it on this camera. Let me see if turning my camera light off will actually help any. Yeah, I think without the light on it's better. It's not as much of a glare. Have to come back and stick blend the fragrance. I've not used this before, so if it happens to rice, then I'll have to come back and stick blend it to get rid of that. But for right now, I'm planning on just hand stirring it in, just because I don't know if this will accelerate trace, and I want it to thicken up, but I don't want it to thicken up too fast on me. Move the green and bring in for the strawberry red. It's all tangled up here and not laying right. That shade right there, I think that will be a nice contrast to the strawberry embeds that I've made to go on top of this soap. So let's scrape as much of this off as I can. Stick that to the side just in case I do have to stick blend the fragrance in. Mess up here, and now bring them both and put a little bit into this one and set that off to the side. seems like it's going to behave pretty well. I may just go ahead and give these each just a quick stick blend, just to be on the safe side. Just because of that little foaming action that it's doing on top of the soap. And all fragrances react differently with your soap. So until you try them, you don't know how they're going to act. Alright, that seemed to have smoothed out that foam, whatever was going on. So let's get this scraped off, then we'll stick blend the red. I'll bring my mold in, and we'll get going with this soap. Because this is a smaller container, let me go ahead and scrape off my spatula and set it to the side for a moment. Got soap all over my hands. We'll throw that rag away. Scrape this down and get going. Alright, stick blender to the side. We'll give this a quick stir. Make sure everything's 100% blended in here. Same with the green again, just give it a quick stir. And I'm probably going to have extra batter than what I need for this particular mold, but that's okay because any extra batter that I do have goes into my sample size molds, and those will go out as soap samples in my orders. Get another paper towel in here. And for those that are wondering about this particular fragrance, this one I get from one of my suppliers that I met through Facebook. It's from Sensational Soaping Supply. The lady that runs it, her name is Julie. She is a wonderful lady. I've not had any problems with any of the fragrances I've ever bought from her. I absolutely love them. She is one of my main go-to suppliers for fragrances. Alright, so I got both of the spatulas out of these. We're going to start off by pouring in a nice layer of the green. And for this today, I'm just going to do my standard drop swirl. It's just back and forth till I get my mold filled. I pour from high up so that as I'm dropping it, the color reaches all the way down in and gives you a really nice drop swirl that way. Air bubbles, if you do not tap them out, will produce little holes in your soap. So I try to tap them out to minimize that as much as possible. Alright, now to finish off the top, I'm just going to start with a light layer of the green the whole way across. Corners and spread it out. This helps ensure that you get your soap batter into all the nooks and crannies. Just a little bit more. One more tap down. Right. Now what I'm going to do with this, one side is going to be green, and the other side is going to be red. The pear embeds are going to go on top of the red section for contrast, and the strawberries are going to go on top of the green for contrast. I may do a little bit of a swirl to the top. If I could speak right today, we'd be in good shape. And that's just going to be to blend the colors in the middle, not on the edges. Grab a skewer. I forgot to grab that. Let's just see if I can get a little swirl to the top for contrast. And this is going to be one of my more flat top soaps, just strictly because of what I'm doing with it. Clean up these edges. Rest of it when I'm finished. So now let's bring in my embeds. Trying to figure out the best way to do this so that I don't cut them with the soap cutter. The strawberries are a bit bigger than the pears. These may be a little bit bigger of a bar of soap than what I normally do. I think it's just going to have to be that way so that I can get the embeds in here the way that I want them. So, drawing my lines on my mold did nothing for me because I never follow them anyway. But that's okay. Like I said, this is in my winter holiday collection, so they can be a little bit bigger of a bar of soap because of that. Let's see. Yeah, I'll get one less bar of soap than what I normally would with this, but I'm okay with that. Like I said, this is just the initial first batch that I've done with this, so it's not a big deal. Go ahead and get some glitter on here. Let's see, let's try a little of this green just for some contrast. If you cannot tell from watching my videos, I do like the use of my glitter. A lot of people think if you use glitter that you're trying to cover up something that you don't like with your soap. But in my case, I just like the way that it finishes it off. But there you have it. There is my Pearberry soap in the mold. When I get this out and cut it, I will do a cutting video. I will attach it to the end of this video. And we'll just see how big of bars we get out of this. Stay tuned for the cutting. Alright, we are back tonight to cut Pearberry soap. This is what it looks like fresh out of the mold. I'm cutting this on my single wire cutter today because the placements of the berries, some of these are going to be a smaller or bigger bar than they normally would be. Darker down here than I normally cut my soaps. I've been gone all day and just got home, so this has had some extra time to sit. Nice and hard already. There we go. Nice pretty swirls in this. I will, because of the placement of my berries and the size of some of these bars, gonna be one less bar of soap than I normally get, but that is all right. Even this up a little bit so it's not such a huge bar of soap. Do my best to try and keep them close to my normal size, but without cutting the berries. You can definitely smell the pear in this. I do rather like it. Very fresh, clean, refreshing fragrance. You smell more of the pears than the berries in it, but that's all right. These smaller pieces that I'm cutting off will just be used for sample pieces. Pretty little watermelon-y, strawberry-ish pink swirl, which is what I was going for. I did not want a harsh red against the light green that I decided to use for the pear color. Trim this one again. I could not find the smaller strawberry mold that I had. I had to go with my bigger strawberry mold. So that's why it's a little bit bigger than I wanted it to fit. camera's really not burning out the colors good at all. It's not doing any justice to the color at all. Cut this one down. Really got to get some better lighting in this basement. But there are those regular bars cut. I want to move this out of the way. I do want to show you what I did do with the remaining batter. I put them into one of my single bar molds. So there will be a couple of these smaller bars available when it's ready as well. Go ahead and pop these out of here. They have the same strawberry and pear on them. And then this one ended up not being quite a full-size bar. So this is going to be mine. And then I also threw some into this Christmas mold. These ones will go out as samples with my purchases. Let's just unmold these real quick. Little green Christmas tree and pearberry set. Oh, I love the way that turned out. Just a little bell. Little candle. I will trim up some of the excess on the edges too. Little Santa head. This is a super duper cute little mold for Christmas. It's the first I've used this mold and I'm really happy with it. Whoops! Throw that candle away. Not really, just kidding. These are releasing super, super easy from this mold. So I may have to do some smaller, cheap, not cheap, but cheaper priced Christmas soaps. I'll just have to figure out the Christmas fragrance blends that I do want to use with this. But it is a really super cute mold. I'm glad I tried it for samples. So some lucky people we'll get to get those as a sample. And then with these, I'm just going to take, cut them straight down the stack. And those will go as sample pieces too. Alright. So I will get this video attached to the other video, get it edited, and I will get it on YouTube. And thank you for watching, and hope you watch my next ones.